Now we move on to WrestleMania 31, 10 years later. And again, I was at this show, Santa Clara, California. This WrestleMania did not have any all-time great WrestleMania matches as far as I'm concerned. However, I thought that this was probably the most solid WrestleMania card from start to finish. Like, I thought almost every match was at least good, and a couple matches close to that great level. Just very solid from start to finish. Probably the low point for me was Triple H and Sting, only because I think WWE did the wrong thing here by having Triple H win and making it about WWE versus WCW when Sting himself cut a promo and said it was not about that. Yet that's all the announcers could talk about. This was better watching live than in person. I hated it watching it back with the announcers just talking about WWE versus WCW. And yeah, it was cool to see the NWO come out there and help Sting, but really didn't make sense. But of course, the big moment was Seth Rollins coming out, cashing in Money in the Bank, another all-time great WrestleMania match. Undertaker Bray Wyatt was good. I like Wyatt doing his, what is that move he does where everybody says, this is creepy, and then Undertaker sits up. Great moment there. John Cena versus Rusev. Rusev coming out with the tank. Good match. Randy Orton and Seth Rollins, another good match. And I love the finish of this one with Rollins going for the curb stomp, but it gets countered into the RKO. Love that finish. And then the ladder match was really solid. Daniel Bryan winning the IC title. Kind of bittersweet because he got hurt again and ultimately had to retire for a couple of years, but this was awesome. Crowd popped huge for his win.